हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम यू ऑल। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द एमफी, दैट इज एसोसिएशन ऑफ म्यूचुअल फंड्स। इट इज अ इंस्टीट्यूशन और इट इज अ एसोसिएशन विच प्राइमरीली वर्क एज अ रेगुलेटर ऑफ म्यूचुअल फंड सेक्टर अंडर द सेबी। सो वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द ऑर्गनाइजेशन, व्हाट आर द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ एसोसिएशन ऑफ म्यूचुअल फंड्स इन इंडिया, इट्स स्ट्रक्चर एंड ओवरऑल फंक्शंस ऑफ एमफी। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विद प्राइमरी इंट्रोडक्शन। द एसोसिएशन ऑफ म्यूचुअल फंड्स इन इंडिया इज अ नॉन प्रॉफिट गवर्नमेंट ऑर्गनाइजेशन इन म्यूचुअल फंड सेक्टर दैट एक्ट्स एज अ प्राइमरी रेगुलेटर अंडर द सेबी। It is a non-profit means its motive is not to achieve the profit from the activity, but it is a market regulator and it is an association of mutual fund in India. Recently, mutual funds were relatively unknown among investors compared to the other investment options, but now the condition is improving. Many people moving towards the mutual fund sector. So this was primarily due to the ambivalence and prevalent myths surrounding it, and the unknown facts which is circulated among the people. So that's why the people are relatively unknown and they do not invest in the mutual funds. MFI is the statutory body like SEBI. Statutory body means it is existed, the institution which is existed according to a special law or the special legislation passed by the parliament. And it is formed to keep investors informed about the mutual fund market. The organization was incorporated on 22nd August 1995, just after the Securities and Exchange Board of India. Security and Exchange Board of India is the total capital market regulator, and MFI is the mutual funds comes in capital market also. That's why SEBI is the main regulator, and under that MFI works as a secondary regulator for the mutual fund sector. And ever since it helps to set various regulations that maintain the ethics and transparency of mutual funds among the Indian investors. So it maintains ethics, transparency, and it sets ideal rules for mutual fund industry, and primarily it helps to protect the interest of the investor. The final interest is to protect the investors who are investing in the mutual fund sector. It is dedicated to develop the Indian mutual fund industry on professional basis, healthy basis, and ethical lines, and to enhance the maintain standard in all areas with a view to protecting and promoting the interest of mutual fund and their unit holders. ARN number we have discussed. ARN number is allotted by the MFI, and ARN number, those who get ARN number who qualifies minimum qualification, and ARN number is required everywhere. You cannot even give the advice that purchase this mutual fund without any MFI registration number, and MFI registration number requires minimum qualification. So indirectly MFI promoting minimum qualification to even give a small tips in the mutual fund. So the standard it is maintaining in this sector. MFI, the association of all the asset management company of SEBI registered mutual fund in India, was incorporated on 22nd August 1995, and it is a non-profit organization. As of now, till the now, there are 43 asset management companies that are registered with the SEBI or its member. So asset management company who are working in the mutual fund, these asset management companies are the member of Association of Mutual Fund in India. AMFI regulate the mutual fund industry. It monitor the mutual fund industry under the SEBI, Securities and Exchange Board of India. Earlier in India, investing in mutual fund was considered risky due to ambiguity and lack of information among people regarding investment and the various myth about mutual funds and share market, stock market, and some kind of unknown things were spread in the among the people. So investor considered mutual fund as a risky asset to invest. The Government of India and Reserve Bank of India initiated the formation of Unit Trust of India, and this is the first mutual fund in India, we all know, to encourage small investor to invest in various money market investment. The journey of mutual fund industry began with the growth of UTI also. Later, the entry of public sector, private sector, international players steadily gave momentum to the industry that empowered its growth. And now the mutual fund industry have a tremendous growth rate. It is expanding every year because of the awareness. This is the AMFI website. You can see here, if we see the last four corners, then first is how it gives the importance to the investor. First is important update. Attention, mutual fund investor and distributor, here one column is given. Then investor special corner is given here. Here footnote is written, click here to know more about mutual fund. Then distributor corner, those who sell the mutual fund, and they can go here. Then research and information is there. I will suggest you visit the AMFI website. You will find many things here. The chief executive of the AMFI is NS Venkatesh, and Balkrishnan Kini is the deputy chief executive. What are the objectives of the AMFI? Why as an association it is established? So we can see if we study the objectives. First objective is to define and maintain high professional and ethical standard in all areas of operation of mutual fund industry. The two words are important here, maintain high professional and ethical standard, means ideal standards should be maintained here, and high professional, the professional people should be here. So the AMFI have the definitions, AMFI define who is the professional and ethical standards. To recommend and promote best business practices and code of conduct to be followed by members and other engaged in the activities of mutual fund and asset management, including agencies connected or involved in the field of capital market and financial services. So AMFI gives the code of conduct, that is the set of ideal rules. Those who are engaged directly or indirectly in this mutual fund industry, so they have to follow this code of conduct. What is code of conduct? Code of conduct is the ideal rule of set given by this AMFI. Then next is to interact with the Securities Exchange Board of India and to represent to SEBI on all matters concerning the mutual fund industry. It is the representative of SEBI. So whatever SEBI has to say in case of mutual fund industry, the AMFI says on behalf of SEBI or as a representative. And the whatever it is going on in the mutual fund industry, AMFI communicate to the SEBI. SEBI is the supreme regulatory of the capital market. Then to represent to the government, Reserve Bank of India and other bodies on all matters relating to mutual fund industry. So it is a government agency, a statutory agency. So it represent as a government, Reserve Bank of India and all other bodies in case of matter which is relating to mutual fund industry. It undertakes nationwide investor awareness program so as to promote proper understanding of the concept and working of mutual funds. You might have heard that advertise mutual funds sahi hai, then mutual funds are subject to market risk, read paper documents carefully, like that. So it is the investor awareness program which is initiated by the MP, and it is a nationwide program, and it is related to working of mutual fund concept, investment in the mutual fund, all these things included for this awareness program, and it is undertaken by the AMFI. To disseminate information on mutual fund industry and to undertake studies and research directly in association with other bodies. So it gives the information about the mutual fund industry to all researcher. We have seen in the last website, here the research and information corner is given. So if we click here, we get the past data to research, then we get the performance of mutual funds, the numbers, different numbers, the members, and different types of schemes, their performance, their returns, all these things we get the data from this website. So indirectly the MP disseminating the information on mutual fund industry and to undertake studies and research directly or indirectly in association with other bodies. To take regulate conduct of distributors, including disciplinary actions, cancellation of MP registration number for violation of code of conduct. So all the punishments who violate the code of conduct and ideal rules set up by the say MP, the cancellation of ARN number and disciplinary actions taken by the MP. If someone find in the violation of code of conduct. And final, which is very important objective of MP, is to protect the interest of investors and unit holder. Protection of investor, those who are investing in the unit of the mutual funds. So unit holder and investor are very important thing. These are the common people, and the protection of their interest, their money, their investment is very important. And according to that, as AMFI takes the very serious action, and it works like SEBI to protect the investors. Even we, the common people, can also complain about the anything if violation is there. Some other objectives are help set uniform and professional ethical standards for all mutual fund related operation. For example, uniform means a similar type of rules regulations. For example, if you invest in a particular mutual fund plan, then after 1 year you don't have to pay exit load. What is exit load? It is a commission of the that particular mutual fund company, asset management company, for handling your fund, handling your investment. So after 1 year you don't have to pay any exit load, any commission. And it is rule set by the AMFI to all the mutual fund and asset management companies. So like that, uniform and professional ethical standard this MP maintains. It ensures that investors and member companies adhere to the regulation and maintain ethical in due course of business. Many times I'm using ethical word. Ethical means we can call it a moral and ideal rules. So the MP maintains the member companies and investors should follow the regulations, maintain ethics in the course of business while doing any activity in this sector. They have to maintain the rules, regulation and ethical standards. Assist, it has a helping role also. It assists to the distributor, advisor, agents, asset management companies and other bodies also, those who involved in the financial service field or capital market, to comply with the set of guidelines. So it helps to follow the or comply with the set guidelines also. It works closely with the SEBI and comply with the mutual fund regulations set by it. SEBI complies it, sorry, it works with SEBI to comply all the regulations and ideal rules set by MP, SEBI, etc. It informs investors across the country about different risks associated with the investing in mutual funds. Make the advertisement, awareness advertisement, then it disseminate the information about mutual fund, where it is risk, where it is not, like that. So it works finally for the benefit of the investors. AMFI is the representative of RBI, SEBI, finance ministry and other bodies related to money market investment also. An important role of AMFI in mutual fund is to distribute information about these investment and also conduct various workshops about different funds. It distributes information and it conducts various training and workshop programs also. It ensures the code of conduct is maintained by everyone involved and also take disciplinary action on event of breach or violation of code of conduct. To safeguard the interest of investor, the All India Mutual Fund Association has also introduced a facility through which individuals can put forth grievances and register complaint also against fund managers or any asset management company also. So the common man also can complaint with this AMFI, and it also submit the grievances also. Inversely, it also helps to safeguard the interest of asset management companies also. What is the role of Association of Mutual Funds? To ensure the ethical standard of mutual fund operation in India, oversee the operation of AMC and mutual fund agents and ensure that they follow the code of conduct, as well as encourage effective business practices also. They encourage effective business practices and they also ensure that the distributor and operations of AMCs, mutual fund agents, to follow the code of conduct. Seeking guidance from SEBI for any issues concerning mutual fund industry, keeping mutual fund industry informed with updated and undertake research activities with other bodies also. Then it ensures distributors operate basis the code of conduct and taking action in case of any violation. The protection of interest of investor is the important role of AMFI. Then the association's presence is instrumental in ensuring ethical practices and transparency in the mutual fund industry. Making investment accessible to new investor by ensuring transparency and by following the ethical values, code of conduct, the investors get the convenience in the investment in the mutual fund. Every fund house or asset management company or fund expert should seek and take the permission from AMFI if they are involved in mutual fund operation and management. So AMFI registration number is the way to take the permission and the approval of the AMFI to work in the mutual fund industry. Without ARN number, you cannot work in the mutual fund industry. And if you want to take the ARN number, then you have to take the minimum qualification, or you have to qualify a minimum qualification in the mutual fund. What are the committees under the AMFI? Over the years, AMFI has steadily worked towards formulating programs to raise investor awareness about mutual fund in India. To make sure that it delivers on each of its objectives, the AMFI has also performed several committees. Some of them include Committee on Operation and Compliance, Committee on Valuation, Committee on Financial Literacy. You can see here, to aware the people, to give the information to the people, the special committee is here, Committee on Financial Literacy, Committee on Registration of Certified Distributor, then AMFI Committee on Certified Distributor, that is ARN Committee, then ETF Committee is there. ETF means Exchange Traded Fund, and for that a special committee is there. The AMFI has a right to withdraw the license of intermediaries under three scenarios. Number one means if three things happens, the AMFI can cancel the license and the approval, that is ARN number of any the person who is involved, or any intermediary who is involved in the mutual fund industry. Number one, violation of the code of conduct. Code of conduct means some ideal rules given by AMFI. If someone violate that, violate means if someone do not follow that rule, then AMFI can cancel their license or can take the disciplinary action. If they commit a serious offense, if they commit, then also AMFI can take the action of cancelling their license. A complaint of negligence which is upheld by consumer court. If consumer court taken some complaint and if negligence is there, then it also can take the action. Broker, agent and companies can renew ARN in two ways. The broker agent can renew the ARN number in different ways we have seen in the last lecture. These are the AMFI members. You can see the most of the asset management companies are the AMFI member. You can see the alphabetically it is started, Aditya Birla Sun Life to Axis Asset Management Company, then DSP Investment Managers, and then elsewhere Eldwes Asset Management, then IIFL Asset Management Company. These are the all members of the AMFI, that is these are the asset management companies which are member of the AMFI. SBI Mutual Fund Management Private Limited is there. So friends, that is from my side in this today's lecture. Thanks for watching. If you find anything difficult, if you want to know anything new, anything extra, or if you have any problems regarding this lecture and in general also, you can ask me on the phone on the message. You can message me, call me, or you can write to me through any mode. Thanks for watching. See you in the next lecture. Bye bye.